Hey, you know what video games are? You know those white things where there's some buttons and stuff happens? You probably do. Who doesn't this day and age? But would you believe me if I said that if you play too much of those games, you might develop a mental health condition? That's what the World Health Organization established earlier this year. They said a compulsive game now qualifies as a mental health condition. Now, this means they'll be speaking to you about trying to defend them and show you that video games aren't this horrible thing that the mass media constantly tries us to think it is. But before that, I'd like to tell a personal story. My personal story with video games. I was introduced to the world of gaming when I was either 9 or 10 years old, and I went to play video games at the house of my friends. Eventually, a close friend of mine introduced me to what would become my first ever console, the Nintendo Wii. And it's not really good for me. The Nintendo Wii had a very casual approach to gaming, because it had motion control games, where you had actions to move in order to play. Thus making life sedentary, where while you were playing. After experiencing it with my friend, I convinced my father to give it to me as a birthday gift. Now here's the important part. The 9-year-old playing Super Mario Galaxy 2 wasn't responsible enough to determine for how long I could play that sounds. So my parents determined that for me. I was only allowed to play video games on Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays after I had studied and done my homework. Because they weren't responsible for me to make that decision, I didn't actually become addicted to video games, but I still managed to complete Super Mario Galaxy 1 and 2 100%, so that was a win-win situation. I have a younger brother. His situation to gaming is similar to mine, but still different than the same. He was raised the same way as I was, but a little bit lighter restrictions. And since he is younger, he has a lot more free time than I do right now. So he passes a lot more time online than me. I'm gonna be honest here. He can be very stubborn when asked to leave the computer to somebody else. But he's not addicted just yet, let's say. Similar to where I'm at yet. It should not be the child's decision, the amount of time they can play. It should be the parents. After all, they are the ones responsible for everything regarding their child. Because the decision that my parents made for me those years ago, I now can decide responsibly for myself for how long and when I can play. In other words, I became responsible for my own actions and didn't become addicted to gaming. And while my brother is still young and not responsible for himself, I'd say that he's not addicted. Now let me change the subject without really changing the subject. There is a game called Fortnite, this one right here, that it's an online multiplayer game that's like Hunger Games, where 100 people fall onto an island, and the last person standing wins. It has become very popular because it's on every platform you can imagine, and it has more than 40 million downloads since last year when it launched. And so in June 11th of this year, there was a new story about a 9-year-old girl from the UK that wet herself while playing Fortnite because she didn't want to leave to go to the toilet. And her mother said that she's now in therapy for the addiction after she became withdrawn, agitated and disturbed from playing up to 10 hours a day. Her parents also reported that she was falling asleep in class and her behavior was more aggressive. Now, is it really fair to blame Fortnite for the addiction and for her behavior? What if the parents had not let the 9-year-old choose how much time she could play? And what if the responsible adults had just controlled over the situation and didn't let her become addicted in the first place? Just like my parents did, for example. So right now, I want to talk about another common thing people say about video games that makes them violent. Let's continue with the Fortnite. There are several media outlets that state that playing Fortnite actually makes you violent. Just a quick Google search on your smartphone can show that. But a survey made by a YouTuber of all things proves that statement to be wrong. The channel The Game Theorists made a video on April 14th of this year where they analyzed the data that they got from their survey about gaming habits and personality type. The survey had more than 330,000 responses from all over the world and came to the conclusion that playing battle royale games like Fortnite doesn't actually make you more violent. In fact, it attracts violent people, not the other way around. Now back to the World Health Organization's statement about addiction on video games being a mental disorder. Christopher psychologist and media researcher at Stetson University in the land, stated that there was a fairly widespread concern that this is a diagnosis that doesn't really have a very solid research foundation. He also said that sometimes gaming overuse can be a symptom that something is going wrong for the child. The likelihood is that the problem is bigger and gaming didn't actually cause it. Okay, enough of specialists going on the matter. Let me say something I've been thinking personally, as a student and as a kid. If gaming and addiction can be considered a mental health disorder, why the other addictive things also be considered as a mental health disorder? For example, we know that our smartphone, something everybody uses every day, can be addictive. Would you stop using your smartphone if I told you that it may cause a mental health condition? But now we've been talking about pretty negative things. How about we change that? And this is some of the positive things that gaming can bring to us. Gaming can bring to us quick thinking, coordination, multitasking skills, good response time, problem solving skills, enhancing memory. And most important of all, especially multiplayer online games can help us improve social skills and promote social events and interaction between people. Let's say, for example, I had less friends than I do now, and I couldn't have as much social interaction as I did. My social interaction level would go down exponentially if I didn't have that. And if I didn't have online gaming, that would go down even further. I couldn't even develop depression if that was the case. In conclusion, we need to stop the stereotypical and negative view on gaming, since it can be very beneficial to us, even in the right amount. And to finish it all off, I'd like to quote Santosh Kaur, who said, "We are addicted to our thoughts. We cannot change anything if we cannot change our thoughts."